Thank you very much.
No problem.
Enjoy.
Thank you.
Have a good one.
Woo. Here we are in the mister, got
yourself in trouble. Kiss. Yeah. Oh, I spoke to so many people.
And 2 hours of waiting, we sort of finally figured out how to check into our Airbnb here.
It was old mate, Sid, who talked to Lucif, who gave a buzz to some London bloke, who looked at the photos and suggested that it could be this building, who gave a call to his boss.
Big, big travel day. Still kicking on. Double, twister, song gonna pull combo.
Scissors, paper, rock. Scissors, paper, rock. Scissors, paper, rock. Yeah, 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 yeah. Mister, got yourself in trouble. Kissed her, now you see in double. Twister, so gonna pull combo. Yeah, 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 yeah. Hey, I showed him coming by, didn't have the sense to make a run. I feel like it's very snobby to be riding around with a SRAM red access gearing. And
literally you roll out, you're in full Lycra, everyone's like, who's this guy? Dude?
Probably the most embarrassing time I felt jumping on my bloody Ventum.
You want to get out of there as quick as possible.
Yeah,
you know?
You don't feel good. You
just some sugar cane drink, $1.50 each. Yeah, limiting sugars, limiting performance.
I'm really looking forward to this meal. What do you reckon? What do you get? Wait, now the next thing you know, they're both taking off clothes and their shoes are left toes and I'm up to my neck. Alright, so get this right. This afternoon, we went to a little desert place. You know, we look like tourists.
Yeah.
You know, it's quite easy in these places like Morocco where you get scammed, where people are like, they charge you for, you know, triple the price to what they charge a local.
Yeah, yeah.
But in this situation, there was this nice lady and she...
In front of the dessert place, selling all these cakes and...
Yeah. And she, I don't know why, but she randomly threw in two extra pastries.
Just chucked him in, just because she was nice and generous.
And so in response, we like paid heaps.
We doubled her generosity and put an extra 10 in.
Put a little tip in.
Generosity gets rewarded with more generosity.
2 kilos of strawberries, 75 cents. That is something that Coles could never match.
Mate, with this Moroccan diet, we're always bloody on the loo, hey?
Just flying through the toilet paper.
Righto, doing a bit of a taper jog now, are we?
Yeah, a little taper jog, little 9Ks, yeah, couple 200s. Yeah, good stuff.
What's the point of taper, Jay?
I don't know, you tell me. Nah, look, I feel like with all your training, so you're constantly training throughout the season, throughout the year for big races, and then you're training the body, you're training the mind to suffer really, really hard. So you're constantly hammering your body, hammering your mind, and then all of a sudden, before the race comes, you take it easy. A couple of days. Our version of tapering is very much getting shorter reps, shorter distances, maybe a little bit faster than race pace.
Keep the intensity up.
Keep the intensity up.
You reckon it works, or is it all just garbage?
That's probably just all garbage.
Okay, there are 3 certainties in life: death, taxes, and waiting for GPS before you start your run.
Wait, let me go get my watch because I left it in the room.
Tuck in or not tuck in?
Bit too much of a dad bod.
Do you reckon cool downs is a thing where it's like pointless, like tapering, you know, just sort of good for the mind, spirit.
Yeah.
I reckon cool downs, you're doing the same thing as what caused you to get the lactic acid. So surely you're just getting more lactic acid.
That's true.
It doesn't really do much. I reckon maybe just sitting in the couch is the best way to cool down, you know?
No, but they say that if you're doing a session and you're not actively recovering, you're going to get lactic acid that way. So it's by not doing a cool down, you build up more lactic acid.
Thank you. What was your name?
Janet. Welcome, Mama.
Thank you. Just making a dinner side purchase for an extra SIM card.
There we go. 100 subscribers.
Yes. Yeah. 100 subscribers.
You don't speak English.
Yeah, you don't speak English.
No.
No?
See you guys later.
Gracias.
So we found a local bakery spot that we always get our Nutella crepe desserts from.
So good.
Here's the guy.
You.
Oh yeah, let's go.
Beautiful.
Yeah, thank you. Changing Instagrams. This guy's famous apparently.
TikTok.
Really?
You TikTok guy, hey?
Yeah.
I'll follow you back.
We'll follow you.
Swim.
Australia, and this is the first time we're in Morocco, and we're doing the African Premium Cup.
Absolute Kraken's place.
Absolutely Kraken.
Yeah, I feel like after a swim, you feel so good. So after the run or ride, you're always sweaty, you're always a bit exhausted, you're always like, I don't know, you just feel a bit yuck, a bit sticky. But after a swim, you hop out, you just feel like, you're so refreshed. The endorphins are just spiking. You feel really nice. You feel like you're really hungry as well, so you feel really great. You feel really good.
Whereas when you're running, you just feel like you just want to sit on the toilet. Viking, you have saddle sores.
Yeah.
During the sport, when you're running, probably the best.
You feel good when you're running. Getting that running high and stuff. And all that jazz that gets talked about in all these running journals and books.
So where does cycling come in then?
Cycling is the most fun, I guess, in terms of the social side. Because you go sit in the coffee shop, or you have all these junk miles that you just talk and chat.
Talk smack.
Yeah. And swimming is just rubbish during it. But
because you can't talk, it's painful most of the time as well.
Oh yes!
Oh yeah!
Ultimately, like, no matter what sport you're doing, Andy, the person that we got invited to the dinner party and played spikeball with, she said something interesting. When we told her like the training structure, she was like, surely you guys are always really happy. Is that something we haven't really thought about before, hey? Right. Like every time you're doing training, you know, you're moving your body, you're outside, you're probably a happier person as a result.
You know, there's no point in doing something if you don't enjoy it, right?
Exactly. You got the stands over there, the DJ set up. Do you want to give us a recap of your last 24 hours?
I'll give you an objective recap.
An objective recap.
And I'll let the audience make an assessment on what my emotional state might be. Bike didn't rock up. That's okay. Having Sarah on.
Hey, boys.
Morocco.
Woo, Morocco.
Yeah, Morocco. Anyway, long story short, I ended up at the airport for 4.5 hours.
Obviously, we've just done a little swim familiarization. Luke has a bit of potential food poisoning. He's feeling a bit unwell, so he didn't.
Just gonna say.
Luke.
Yo, literally got skin.
Oh no.
His face is a different colour.
It's literally green. Bit of a spew this morning, Luke.
Bit of a spew.
Damn.
It's not looking good for tomorrow, but yeah.
Getting the potion juice. How the turntables. I was sick yesterday, now Jaden's bloody sick today. Worst part is, it's bloody race day today. T-minus 4 hours till gun time. But hey, look, we're still getting to the line.
Now from the race, I'm feeling very, how you going? No idea whether I'm actually still gonna be racing or not. I haven't eaten any in ages. That's crazy.
That's the risk you take from going to Morocco. Race done. Not the best race, hey Chris?
Let's just go on.
Chris is done with the whole Europe thing, hey? He was traveling, he only had one training. Somehow finished the race. He's half green now, he's turned into an alien.
I had a bit of a weird issue where the tape I put around my foot to stop blisters came off in the swim and was dangling, and then got in the jockey wheels and derailleur and cassette of the bike and had to stop, yank out the tape, but it couldn't really get the tape out, so that was race over for me. That's racing, isn't it, Chris? That's racing.
Food poisoning hits you hard, doesn't it? Just slept all day. Birds flying high, you know how I
feel. So Morocco.
Gonna say food wasn't its strong point. It sort of did ruin our race, but I think what we gotta learn from this is that this whole trip can't purely just be based around the racing. I mean, you can psych yourself up with the racing, obviously, and trying to get a good result, but in the end of the day, like,
we're still having fun, right?
We're still having fun. People go to Europe and don't do racing and still have a good time. Having a good result is obviously something that would make this trip, you know,
amazing. I guess what, in Morocco in general, the number one thing that I noticed is, wow, the people are amazing. They're just so helpful, so willing to you know, make you feel welcome. They're so willing to just say hello, even though they don't speak your language. We're literally racing yesterday, and people are yelling out, oh, welcome to Morocco! Like, it's so cool, hey. Probably one of the coolest race locations I've ever been. I guess the main difference, though, between London and Morocco, London was definitely, like, too comfortable. It was easy living. You know, English-speaking, Western developed country, living in Morocco, you're almost an observer in a different culture. Anyway, this summarizes the Morocco episode. There was probably more waffle in this last piece at breakfast this morning. See you later, Morocco. Fish in the sea.